We explored the intensification of treatment, the sequential intensification of treatment in patients with the relapsed refractory disease in the IMPROVE study. And the IMPROVE study was designed to start with venetoclax alone, because venetoclax, BCL2 inhibitors, is able to induce very deep responses, achieving undetectable MRD in both the peripheral blood and bone marrow. And therefore, with the idea that those who achieved undetectable MRD could stop the treatment and be followed up after 1 year of treatment. Those who did not achieve undetectable MRD, then they would have an intensification of treatment by adding ibrutinib, so a BTK inhibitor, for an extra year. And any time during the extra year of the combination, whoever reached the undetectable MRD could stop the treatment. And then those who did not reach undetectable MRD after 2 years, after 1 year of venetoclax and 2 years of the second year of combination, then they would continue ibrutinib as a continuous therapy, really indicating that those were more refractory patients and could benefit, as we know, by continuous treatment with BTK inhibitors. And the interesting point is that only 8% of the patients were those who did not achieve undetectable MRD with this strategy, and they were bound to receive continuous ibrutinib, hopefully until progression. So this is somehow responding or showing the way under two points. The first one is that we can use MRD assessment to define the length and the intensity of treatment. And second, that we don't need to use all the treatments, all the drugs together in every patient. Some patients can achieve very deep responses with one drug. Some others will need two. Maybe some others will need three. So one could even prolong the study adding other therapies, but always with using MRD as our endpoint to stop the treatment.